Hello everyone. So yesterday we studied about the rectangular glass slide, and that was a reflection through a rectangular glass slide. As well as we studied yesterday two types of curved mirrors. That was a concave mirror and a convex mirror. We also saw what is called a principal axis, the focus, radius of curvature, as well as the center of curvature. Fine students, and I hope you are clear about that topics. I also told you that the radius of curvature R is always equals to 2f. R is equals to 2f. Okay. One more thing what we will study is today, that is the various situations of the image formation by concave mirrors. Okay. We are going to study 6 cases of image formation by concave mirrors. In concave mirror, we saw that the inner cone surface area was known as concave mirror. But in that concave mirror, we also saw that the image formation is always real and inverted. As well as in convex mirror, we saw that it is always virtual and erect. So how they are forming the images, that we need to see today. In all, there are 8 cases, 6 of concave mirrors and 2 of convex mirrors. Usually these questions are being asked in the examinations in 3 marks each, where you need to write the object position, image position, size of the object, that means the height of the object, and the image formation, that is either it is real and inverted or it is virtual and erect, as well as you need to draw the whole figure. Fine, it is quite important for the examinations, and so you need to learn this. Today I am going to start with the image formation by concave mirrors, that is the first at infinity. Okay, so let us draw this. So the first topic is at infinity. At infinity. Okay, so the first thing is we will draw a concave mirror. In exit in between of that, we will draw a pole, and that pole P is said to be P. Okay, now we need to draw the focus as well as the double distance of that center of curvature. You can make the arbitrary values of the center as well as focus, it will work. Okay, now what the thing is, we need to keep the object at infinity. The question written over here is the position given of the object. Position given of the object means if there is a curved surface, concave mirror in front of us, and I am standing at infinity, what will be the figure given? Or what will be the image formation that we need to see? Say for example, an object of height, this, is standing over here. So, and name this as A and B, that is the height of the object. Fine students, now what happens? The first ray will strike over here and it will bend towards the focus. And it will come over here. I hope you are clear with these things. Now next thing will be what? And another ray is coming from here and it is striking back. It is striking back. So where both the rays gets intersect, it is the point where the image is formed. I repeat, where both the points of incident ray intersect each other, it is the point where the image is formed. And so the image is formed over here at the focus. So if you will keep the object distance, see this OD stands for object distance students. This OD stands for object distance. So if the object distance is at infinity, then image distance is found at focus. It is found at focus. Now you can see that the object was as big in size, that is AB, but just now what we can see over here is just a dot. So you can say that the whole big image is converted into a small diminished point sized object, and so the size of the object will be point sized. So it will be point sized. Fine students, I hope you are clear with this. It is point sized object, and the image formation will be of course real and inverted. Real and inverted. Okay, I hope you are clear with the first thing. If the object was kept at infinity, the image distance is formed at focus. The size of the object will be point size, and the object, the formation of the image will be real and inverted. The formation of the image will be real and inverted. So I hope you are clear with these things. Okay students, let us move on to the next thing, and that is beyond C. See, over here they are telling us about, if I have kept the object beyond C. Now beyond C stands for near to center of curvature and more nearer than that of infinity. Okay, so that is the beyond C, and that is the object distance given to us. Again, we need to do what? We need to draw a concave mirror. Draw the straight line passing through this, and this will be your pole. This will be your focus, and of course, this will be your center of curvature C. Now, what happens if you are keeping an object over here? Okay. You are keeping an object over here. The first ray will go as similar to that of first, that it will strike over here and then passes through focus, and then passes through focus. The second ray will go through the center of curvature and then strike back. Okay. So where the two points get intersected, that is the formation of the image. Where the two points get intersected, that is the point of intersection. So here is the point where the two points got intersected, and that is the image formation. So what we need to do, over here we need to draw an arrow which is inverted. So if the object size was AB, the image size will be A prime B prime. So students, you can see that the object was bigger in size. Now the image formation is smaller than that of the object. Of course, you can see that the size of the image is smaller than that of the object. Okay, and where the image is being formed, it is between C and F, that is between the center of curvature and focus. Between center of curvature and focus. So here you can write between C and F, that is your image distance. That is your image distance. You can also see that the object is small in size and it is not point size. If you can see only point over anything, then it is said to be a point size. But here the object is quite bigger than that of point size, so you will write diminished. Diminished stands for small sized object. You can also write in a simple English, that is small sized. Small sized. And one and the same thing we will be repeating over here. This was also real and inverted. This is also a real and inverted. So we need to write over here, it is real and inverted. Fine students, I hope you are clear with these things. When the object was kept at beyond C, the image distance formed was between center of curvature and focal length. Now, if the image formation is between C and F, so it is small in size as compared to the object distance, as well as it is real and inverted. As well as it is real and inverted. I hope you are clear with this. Let us move on to the next thing, and that is asked many times in the examinations also, that is at C. So the third figure what we are going to draw is at C. Here the word at C stands for at the center of curvature. At the center of curvature. So at
सी दैट इज एट द सेंटर ऑफ कर्वेचर. द सेम थिंग वी आर गोइंग टू डू, वी विल ड्रॉ अ कॉनकेव मिरर. फाइन, वी आर गोइंग टू ड्रॉ अ स्ट्रेट पोल पासिंग थ्रू द मिरर दैट इज पी. The exact distance from here will be focus. The double the distance will be the center of curvature. Now, what our question is that we need to see. They are asking us that the object is kept at the center of curvature. That the object is kept at the center of curvature. So, what happens? If the object is kept over the center of curvature, same thing happens. It passes through the focus after reflecting from the mirror and over here. Now what happens? And another ray that passes through here, it will get reflected over here somewhere. Okay, so you can see that the image formation is exactly at the C only. So here we can conclude that if the object distance was kept at C, if the object distance was kept at C, the image formation will be also be at C, that is the center of curvature. So at C was the object distance, then at C will be the image distance. At C is the object distance and at C will be the image distance. See, if you can write over here, write AB as your original object and the image formation will be A prime B prime, that was inverted. I hope you are clear with this. So the next thing is, if the image is formed at the same place where the object is being kept, that means the size of the image remains same. So what we need to do over here is, we need to write that it is same size of the object. We need to write over here that it is same size of the object. It is same size of the object. And the same thing we need to write, that is real and inverted. This is real and inverted. I am writing in a short form due to the scarcity of space. Real and inverted, R and I stands for real and inverted. So I hope you can understand over here, if the object was kept at the center of curvature, object distance, then the image distance will be the same at C. Okay, I hope you are clear with these things. The same size of the object and real and inverted. You please go through this, it is quite important. Next topic what we need to see is fourth. And that is between C and F. Between C and F. Okay. Between C and F, they are telling us. That means the center of curvature and focus, in between of that, we need to keep our object. Okay. So the same thing we will repeat. We are going to draw a concave mirror. Okay. Then we are going to draw a pole that will name something like P. The focus will be our F. The center of curvature will be our C. Now what they are telling, that between C and F is our object distance. Here OD stands for object distance. Okay. So what we need to write? We need to keep this like this in between. Okay, so what happens if one of the ray goes through here, it will strike back at the focus. And one of the ray will go towards here and they will go from this center of curvature. So they will meet somewhere at here. Okay, this is quite an idea, but if you draw in a book with a scale, it will be neat and clean.
So the object is found somewhere over here, that is also real and inverted. I hope you are clear with this. If the object is the size AB, then image will be A prime, B prime. It will be A prime, B prime.
So students, here you can see that when the object was kept between center of curvature and focus, the image distance found was beyond C. It was found beyond C. Okay. Now you can also see that the image formation is very large than that of object. Okay. The image formation is very large than that of object. So you also need to write that the size of the body is enlarged. Size of the body is enlarged. And the same thing, real and inverted. Okay, so I hope you are clear with this. Find that between C and F the object distance is there, then beyond C will be the image distance. The size of the object will be enlarged, real and inverted. Enlarged, real and inverted. Okay, so this was the figure what you need to draw in the examinations if it is asked. Next thing, fifth we are going through. So what is the fifth topic over here? If the object is kept at focus, if the object is kept at focus, fine. So that is the first thing. So first of all, we will write over here that the object is kept at focus. Name it as F, that is your object distance. Okay, now what we will do? Draw a concave mirror over here. Okay, now the same thing we are going to repeat every time. This is your pole. This will be your something we call as focus. This will be your center of curvature. This will be your center of curvature. See, if the object was kept at focus itself, the ray will go over here. The ray will go over here. It will go something like this. Okay, so this is the incident ray. And the another ray which was going will strike over here and then it directly passed to the center of curvature. So students, you can see over here that the two rays are not intersecting. The two rays which are passing, that went over here and then they are going over here, are not intersecting with each other. They are not intersecting with each other means the image formation will be at infinity. The image formation will be at infinity. Please keep attention over here. If the pole, focus and center of curvature and the focus, at focus we are keeping the object distance, then the image formation will be at infinity. Find at infinity. So this will be your image distance. So this will be your image distance. One more thing, of the body, if it is found, it will be very large in size. So you need to write very large in size. And one more thing, of course it will be real and inverted. Okay, so I hope you are clear with the fifth element, that is at focus object distance, then image distance will be at infinity. Then the image distance will be at infinity. Okay, and the size will be very large. The size will be very large in size. It is real and inverted. So we are moving towards the sixth term, and that is, they are telling us between P and F. Here P stands for pole, F stands for focus. Okay students, and this is your object distance. This is your object distance. So what happens, again we will draw a concave mirror And if you are keeping this as a pole, this as your focus, and this as your center of curvature, then we need to keep the object between P and F. Between P and F. Fine. So what happens? Your object will be somewhere over here. Okay. Now what happens over here? One of the ray will get over here, and one of the ray will strike over here, and the imaginary line will be passing through this. Okay, the focus. And the another ray will be something like this. So these also they cannot meet. Of course, I hope you are clear with this. The first ray goes over here, it strikes, goes back. It goes over here. Okay, mistake, sorry. Let us do once again. So if I have a concave mirror and I am going to draw this, so I will be having a pole over here, focus and the center of curvature. Fine, I hope you are clear with this. So now what happens? If the object was kept between P and F, object was kept between P and F, then what happens? The first ray will strike over here and then it directly passes through the focus. And then it directly passes through the focus. The next ray that was going to strike will be something like this, and then it will pass through center of curvature. So students, you can see over here that the arrows are emerging and not diverging, and so we cannot say that there will be an intersection point over here. But we can draw the imaginary lines from this diagram. We can draw the imaginary lines from this diagram. You please pay attention over here. So out of these 5, 6, this was a different one. Dash, all the 5 were same. Okay. So this is C, this is F, and this is what we call the center of curvature, and the ray is passing through this. Now what happens if both the rays are not going to intersect each other? We can draw a imaginary line over here as well as over here. And so what happens? You can find an image behind the mirror. An image is found behind the mirror. So you can write this thing as A, this thing as B, then this will be your A prime, this will be your B prime, and this is your image formation, and this is your image formation. Okay, I hope you are clear with this. So what will be the change over here? First of all, you need to write that the image is formed behind the mirror. Okay, image is formed behind the mirror. Behind the mirror. One more thing, now it is not inverted. As you can see over here, it is not inverted like this, this, this or that. Okay, so if it is straight but behind the mirror, we will name it as virtual and erect. Virtual and erect. One more thing, size will be enlarged. Size will be enlarged. I hope you are clear with the sixth element. If the object distance was between P and F, then the image distance will be behind the mirror. Image distance will be behind the mirror. And as it is not inverted, it won't be real. And so it is virtual and erect. It is virtual and erect. And the size is, of course, the size of the AB is smaller than size of the A prime B prime. So we can say that it is enlarged. Okay. So this was the 6 cases of the image formation by concave mirrors. Have you noticed one thing over here? See, the first case was at infinity. The first case was at infinity. Then the image distance what we found was at focus. Now take this fifth element that was at focus. Then the image distance distance is found at infinity. So it is the inverse of all. The 1st and the 5th resemble. Okay. The 1st and the 5th will resemble each other. That if the object distance is at infinity, image distance will be at focus. And if the image object distance will be at focus, image distance will be at infinity. You can check the second also. If it is beyond C in second, then image distance will be between C and F. The same thing is being repeated over here. Fourth, if the object distance is between C and F, then the image distance will be beyond C. Then the image distance will be beyond C and F. Beyond C. So we can also say that the second and fourth are also resembling over third. Third is quite common. Okay, third we saw that if the object distance is at C, then image distance is also at C. Okay, image distance is also at C. So the same thing is observed, no change in size is observed at C. If they are asking the question in MCQ that where will be the image formation or where will you keep the object distance, if there will be no change in the size of the object, then you need to write at the center of curvature. At the center of curvature will be your final answer. I hope you will get it, students. Okay. So third is resembling and the sixth was quite different. That was between P and F. That was between P and F. That is between principal axis, also the pole, and focus, the object distance. Then behind the mirror you will get the image distance. Behind the mirror you will get the image distance. And so it will be virtual and erect and enlarged. Virtual, erect and enlarged. So these were the 6 cases of image formation by concave mirrors can be asked in your examinations for 3 marks. Fine. The writing criteria will be, first of all, they will give us the object distance. Then we need to find the image distance and write. You need to write the size, that it is either small, diminished, point size, enlarged or very large. And then you need to write the nature of image formation. The nature of image formation in the 5 cases of concave mirror will be same, that is real and inverted. But in the last case it was being changed, and that is from real and inverted to virtual and erect. So these were the 5 cases what we did today about the image formations of concave mirrors. Fine. The 2 cases of the image formation by convex mirror we will be continuing tomorrow. Fine. Your homework will be the 6 cases you need to write this. I hope you are clear with this, and if you are having doubt, please contact me. Thank you.